My name is Yuka Uchida. I'm a member of Triple Nipples. I'm a vocalist and a performer. I'm from really countryside of Japan. And it's like Tokyo, it's like fantasy land. It's so much neon, so many people, amazing art, music's everywhere. People are learning crazy stuff. Like, I was so excited to, you know, move here.
Hey!
Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Nice to see you. Good.
Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you too. Oh, you see that this is like really normal soccer field, mm-hmm. and not many people know about it. But this, underneath of soccer field, there's one of the most magnificent places in Tokyo, and we're gonna go check
under
it out.
Here?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so okay. Let's go check it out.
Whoa.
Check this out.
Oh.
My God, right?
Oh, wow.
Isn't it amazing?
Oh, my God.
Right? Japan's like built on the fault line, so like natural disasters like all around us, earthquake, tsunami, like flood, monsoon, this will all fill up with water when a typhoon comes or like monsoon season, like river flooded, and that all the water comes into here and push into the ocean.
Wow.
Isn't it amazing?
Yes. Crazy.
The tunnel goes for like 6 kilometers from river to ocean. Yeah, let's get down there and check this out. It took 17 years and it took like $2 billion. So it's like massive money. So government put so much money into it to protect their own people.
Quicksand! Quick thunder! Use your magic wand! Get the hell out of here! Okay, we should turn around before we get stuck.
So government built the Tokyo city itself to be resilient. So people were feeling safe. But after 3/11, this like sense of safety that we always have is now gone.
Now, where were you for 3/11?
I was in the subway.
Oh, wow.
So the train rail has this system, like has an earthquake sensor. So the train stopped and then went like that. I was like, oh my God. Wow, this is kind of like apocalyptic, you know?
Yeah, I would have been shitting bricks. yeah, for sure.
We had to get out of the train.
Yeah.
And I got to, you know, walk down the underground tunnel.
Yeah. And how was that?
I was really excited. You don't get to, you know, walk underground of Tokyo. Not really. And get overground. And then I saw this, like, footage of, like, Sendai, Fukushima. And I was, what is happening? Like, it's just really unrealistic. And, yeah.
Wow.
This is like on world biggest drains. It's beautiful. People in Japan are not really sure about the government or the security or whether tomorrow is promised.
When new fears are introduced to you,
yeah.
that were there all along, but you never knew until like reality kicks in. It's a very scary thing.
Yeah.
Well, this is awesome.
でももう豊かどころじゃないじゃん、うん、最低限のレベルさえもうこんな食べるものも気をつけなくちゃいけないし飲む水ももうこれはどこ産なんだろうとか 放射能の被害を少なくして生きていかなくちゃいけないんだろうってことをすごい考えなくちゃいけなくなる。
素人のランっていう、まあ、集まりっていうかグループっていうか、まあ、名前でいろいろお店を出したりするんですけど、3回やったんですけど、その原発の高円寺で1万5000人で、渋谷で1万5000人で、新宿で2万人
まあ開けたらすごい1万人以上人が集まっちゃって、ほんとびっくりして、それはやっぱみんな世界が変わっちゃったから。
です。力点マガジンっていう雑誌を作ってます。で、日本人は結構シャイだったり、で、僕もそうだかもしれない。こう公にすることってすごく怖いことだと思う。なんか裸で自分みんなの前に立つみたいな。だけれども、こういう自分の得意なアートとか、もっとかっこいいやり方、違うやり方みたいなのをやったらかっこいいんじゃないかなと思って、で、そうやって社会を変えていくことがちょっとでもできたらすごく面白いなと思って、僕たちよりは明らかに30代、40代、50代、60代の人たちの責任が重いはずなのに、そういう人たちが躍起になって騙されてたとか、安全だって言ってたじゃないか、保証はどうするんだとか、都電潰せばいいとか、そういうこと全く自分の反省なしに言ってしまうこと、第1号本当にチャレンジャーとして始めたやつは全くもうバーコード入れなきゃ流通できないなんてことも知らなくて、一軒一軒その置いてもらいたいなっていう本屋さんに行って置いてもらえませんか、なんか本当そこら辺のガキみたいな、友達の女の子とか女子高生の友達の制服着てこうやって雑誌持って置いてくださいとか言うとポンポン置いてくれるみたいな大人ってなんかもうすごいものだと思ってた、本当になんか結構変わんない、あんまり友達となんか結局女の子が行けばボンボン置いてくれたり、なんかそういうことでなんかもうこれ遊べるなみたいなあ、行ける行けると思って。